What's up, my friends? Today we're gonna build a mini CNC plotter machine. First of all, what is a CNC machine? CNC, or better said, computerized numerical control, which basically means that a computer controls the movement of a machine. In our case, we are going to make an interesting, cheap and easy to build CNC plotter, which will plot up to 5x5cm logos. Let's first watch this example of what we are going to build. So, as you could see, we basically have a machine moving into three axes. We first have to build the actual machine, after that we are going to look at the electronic parts. Every CNC machine usually uses step motors, because they are very precise. In our case, we will use some small step motors that we could find in any DVD burner. We'll need a total of 3 motors, one for each axis. To control the movement of the motors, we are going to use an Arduino microcontroller. We will send G-code from a PC via USB using a program called Universal-Gcode-Sender. So, let's get started! First of all, we are going to disassemble 3 CD or DVD burners. Let's look what's inside of a DVD burner. We open the case and we see this. Usually, there is a brushless motor that spins the CD. We could use that for another project. There is a DC motors too, that opens the slide. All we need is this, a small step motor with 2 fine rods. We screw that out. You can tell that it's a step motor because of these 4 inputs. We'll need 3 of these. Now that we have our axis, we start building the frame. Let's look at this 3D design of the machine. We will first need a base. We'll use a wood plate, in my case 13x17cm. We'll use 2 19 degrees corners to put our X and Z axis in place. Next, we'll add the support plate. I 3D print this part, but you could use a wood plate if you don't have a 3D printer. I'll give all the dimensions in the link below, so you could cut out all the parts. Next, we screw in place the Y axis that we took out of the DVD burner. This part will make the movement in the Y direction. Next, we add the X axis. To lift and load the pen, we'll need a Z axis. And the design is complete. Okay, so we cut the wood plate in the required dimension. We drill out holes for 4 screws in the right position to fit in these 4 holes of the Y axis. We put on some spacers and we add the Y axis. Make sure that the axis is level. We add the 19 degrees corners and do the same for the other 2 axes. I will add some 3D files if you want to print this part instead of using metal parts. Next, we put in place the X-axis along with the wood or 3D printed plate. We use this part to easily attach the X-axis and screw it in place. Next, I drill 3 holes in the X-axis so I can screw in place the last part, the Z-axis. I attach the Z-axis to the wood or 3D printed part and use 3 screws to join the X-axis and the Z-axis together. I've added a double square table on the Y axis so I could level it. To finish the body, I've added a pen cap that will support the pen. There are other projects that are using burn-in lasers or DC motors instead of a pen to draw their files. Finally, we solder 4 wires to each motor long enough to reach the back of the machine, and we are done! Now, let's take a look at the electronics. We'll use an Arduino microcontroller with a garbled program uploaded to it. But first, we have to build our PCB. I've used a double-sided drill PCB. First, I've soldered in place the Arduino Nano pins. Then, I started soldering in place some female's 8-pin columns. This is where the stepper control will fit in. It has 16 pins, and we are going to use 3 of them, one for each motor. So, we solder 6 columns of 8 pins separated 4 rows between them. Once everything is in place, we solder the connection using wires. You can download the schematics in a link below. First, I've soldered power and ground to each module. After that, I made the connection according to these schematics. The electronic part is ready. All we need to do is connect the motor pins in place, connect 12 volts to the PCB and add the A4988 steppers modules and upload the garbage program to the Arduino. To upload the code, we will use a software named Xloader. You can download it from a link below. We open the program and select Arduino Nano as a device. We select our COM. In my case, it's COM9. You should download the hexadecimal file in the link below. Once you download it, open it up in the Xloader program and click Upload. You'll see that the transmission LEDs of the Arduino are blinking. Once the upload is complete, open the Universal-Gcode-Sender program that you can download in the link below. Select the COM of your Arduino and click Open. You'll see that the connection is established. Remember to connect 12 volts to the PCB input. Now, if you go to commands line and type $, you'll see that some settings appear on your screen. To change these settings, just type $ and the number of the configuration that you want to change. Insert the value and press Enter. We have to change the step per centimeters of our motors. In my case, my motors need 64 steps to make 1 centimeter. After we change the values, we are ready to make the test. We go to the file window and open the example G-code file that you can download in the link below. We click send and enjoy the show. To create my G-code files, I've used Flatcam software. I left a link in the description where you can download this program and convert your Gerber file to G-code. Thanks again and see you in my next video!